Hello students, welcome to this module number 3. Today we are going to discuss about the chapter the heat treatment, ferrous and non-ferrous alloys. Okay, so let us discuss beginning of this introduction part of the heat treatment, and then further we have to discuss in detail about the contents. Okay, so every metal has its set of properties. Okay, even take any of the material, brass, copper, steel, silver, any material you take, it's having their its own properties like strength, ductility, toughness, heat resistance, there is corrosion resistance, like that. So the heat treating is also a group of industrial or metal working process used to alter their physical and sometime chemical properties of the material. So to change their improve their properties or changing some properties, so we have to do some heat treating on that material. Okay, either it may be change physical or chemical properties. Okay, then next one is the most common application in a metallurgical. The heat treatment is also one of the important manufacture of a company and other used in manufacture company and other materials such as a glass. Okay, even for the heat treatment involves used for heating or chilling, normally to extreme temperatures to achieve a desired result, such as hardening or softening of the material. So that is the word heat treatment means not only for giving rising the temperature of the metal, so either also it will be cooling also, is there. That is what we call chilling. So the heat treatment means either it may be increase the heat or decrease the temperature, increase the temperature or decrease the temperature, so to get the desired results. So next let us discuss about what is how it is going to be considered for the different material for the heat treatment, and that we will discuss in the next slide. And next one is, there is a TTT diagram. Okay, so what is meant by TTT diagram? So this is an iron carbon phase diagram. It gives a clear picture of the different phase presenting and corresponding the microstructure of different metals, okay, under equilibrium conditions. So however, that the iron carbon phase diagram does not give any information so on phase transformation, that is start to end of the phase transformation it gives, and it also a transformation to different types of crystal structure also it will gives. And since this differentiate different rates of cooling of the some alloy composition, it yields different phases, and it also important to know the effects of phase transformations. Okay, so this a TTD diagram is a plot of what we call temperature versus logarithmic of time for metals or alloys. See, on the y axis the temperature will be there in degree centigrade, and on the x axis the time will be there along y x axis, that is in seconds. So the diagram also known what we call the S curve. Okay, because the shape of that curve that shows in the shape of S, that's why we call it the S curve, or sometimes Bain's curve or isothermal transformation, that is IT diagram. So, and shows the relationship between the temperature and the time taken for the decomposition of transformation to take place a metal when it is transformed, allow the to occur the constant temperature, that is what we call the time temperature transformation diagram. Okay, let us we'll discuss how it is going to be constructed, TTD diagram. So first step, what we have to do, there are certain steps are there to get the diagram. Okay, first a number of small specimen of the steel are going to be cut in the form of same bar and made ready according to the test conditions. Okay, and second, what we have to do, that the same sample are going to be heated in a furnace to temperature above attractor temperature of around more than 720 or 727 degrees centigrade, at which the austenite is stable and the complete austenite phase is going to be formed in a microstructure. Okay, that we are observed. Okay, in the microscope level, we can observe these things. And third step is very important. Once if we get the specimen, then kept in a molten salt bath, so at a constant temperature, at below the 727 degree centigrade, or that is austenite temperature. So what we have to do, for the certain time duration, the more time it gives a specimen to react with the isothermally, and it more a perlite is going to be formed. So as the temperature changes and it is the form of decomposition or the material, it goes changes their property. So material, it becomes perlite, and this specimen is withdrawn from the bath, and rapidly it is going to be quenched in cold water. So then it is automatically converted into untransformed austenite into martensite. So the volume of which can be estimated also we can in a microscopic level. And this above steps what we discussed now, that is going to be repeated for remaining specimen at different constant temperature, say 500, 550, 650, 700, like that. So you are going to decrease, okay, 500, 550, 600, 650, like that. So, and time duration also you can note down. So finally, this moisture microstructure is going to be examined at room temperature. Okay, so that is going to be examined at room temperature, then it becomes different forms. And the final last step is what we have to do, that exothermal reactions curves also known, that is the S shape, and that is curve, and R is going to be drawn, and by plotting this percentage transformation on the y axis, and logarithmically of time at different temperature on the x axis is going to be drawn. And for this plot shows the S curve, and for only for the two different temperatures. So this S shape of curve gives a transformation on time of the beginning and the completion of the transformation of the austenite. So these are all about, see, this structure is going to be in the form of S. So that S curve, it gives all the details of different forms, that is here the initially it will be martensite and bennite, and finally it reaches to the perlite. So this is all about the TT diagram for, and the well, finally what our one more step is there, that is if when the data is obtained from a series of S curve, and the whole temperature range of austenite is going to be instability and reaches instability for a given composition of steel is going to be summarized, and the result, the TTD diagram of steel is going to be get. So this is how the steps of involved to get the TTD diagram. It is the time transformation temperature time transformation curve. Okay. Let us discuss about one more TT diagram, that is for eutectoid steels. Okay, again this is also microstructures obtained at different cooling rates is expanded. Okay, suppose if you take this eutectoid steel containing of 0.3 around 0.8 above 0.8 percentage of carbon, so this is the shape of curve. Okay, so let us discuss about this steel. That is, first step is for austenite is stable about 727 degrees centigrade, but unstable below 727 degrees centigrade because of it transform into a perlite, bennite, and or martensite. So a temperature between 727 degree and approximately reaches to 550 degree centigrade, the transformation occurs to produce a laminar structure like of perlite, and at temperature of this just below the 727, so it nucleation is going to be formed, that is a nucleation of cementite is going to be formed from the austenite. It will be a very slowly it will occur, so but the diffusion is going to be a diffusion and growth of nuclei will be proceed a maximum speed to produce a coarse perlite. Okay, as the transformation of temperature is lowered to about 550 degree centigrade, which is the what we called a nose, this point we called as nose. Okay, this point nose, and or we called as the knee of the TTT curve. So perlite changes from coarse to a fine structure. So this is about the 0.83% of carbon of eutectoid steels. So at the temperature just below 550 degrees centigrade, the diffusion is very slow, and it such as the transformation time increases, so slower the rate of diffusion is occurs, and the carbon of atoms in austenite transforms the austenite into a new product called what we call, that is a bainite. Almost is the catalyst of martensite. So the microstructure consists of a non-laminar retractile structure, that is alpha, that is ferrite and cementite, that is Fe3C, is going to be formed. And the bainite, which is formed just below the 550 degree centigrade, just you can above this bainite where it is formed, there is this along the vertical axis, that is y axis, the temperature will be there, and along the axis time will be there. You can observe the different form of steel, erectile steels. Okay. So in a quenching, suppose if you want to quenching the down to about a 40 degree centigrade, 240 degree centigrade, the temperature of drops rapidly to a point. So low that diffusion becomes too small for the formation of the nuclei. So austenite changes the incompletely into a distorted body and centered structure, that is what we call the crystal structure, what we discussed, that is BCC, with little and no diffusion of carbon into a particles of cementite and to form a martensite. So and finally we can discuss about this martensite. Suppose ceases to there is a final temperature, so then all austenite should have transformed to martensite. But what happened, the frequently in practice a small portion of the austenite does not transform because of a larger volume fractions of austenite are rained in some highly allied steels. Okay, so where the martensite final temperature is well below the room temperature. So this is about the TT diagram for retractite steels. So the rest of the things we'll discuss in the next video. Thank you.